even though we have been holding, we have continued with some of the tasks that need to be conducted. They're in the process of putting on the pressure suits that the crew will wear on future missions. This particular suit room, there's mission specialist Pinky Nelson, who has on his launch and entry helmet, Dave Hilmers, who is in the process of completing his suiting up process as well. In the foreground, Commander Rick Hauck, in the process of putting on his pressure suit. And then in the background, you can see mission specialist Mike Lounge waving at the camera there, and the other crew around the room.
PCSD. Yes, sir. For the ASP, are you going to stow the extra 5 amp fuse with the crew?
I was just going to ask somebody if I should do that.
And the flight crew emerging from the elevator and on their way out the door now, led by security. The Commander Rick Hauck, Pilot Covey, Mike Lyons, Dave Comers, and Pinky Nelson, followed by Don Putty, who is the head of the flight crew office in the Johnson Space Center. Crowd of news media representatives also there to document their leaving. The crew now in the Astro van and preparing to close the door. The Astro van now on the pad surface. And the crew ready to get out. They'll be met by a couple of the closeout crew technicians. This is Shuttle Launch Control at T-minus 2 hours, 27 minutes, and counting. Commander Rick Hauck in the white room where he is completing the suiting up process. Obviously, had either brought along or was handed a gag set of glasses in which he did try on there. The team helping take off the protective booties, which have been on the boots that he wears as part of the pressure suit, shaking hands with the closeout crew, and obviously being wished luck.
Copy. CMQC, OTC, step 410.
Copy.
Dave was a U.S. Marine pilot prior to joining NASA, and he logged more than 1,500 hours.
Long count follows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
This is Shuttle Launch Control at T-minus 20 minutes, 48 seconds and counting. We're just a few seconds away now from the T-minus 20-minute hold. and we will stop the clock at that point.
Flight NTD on air ground one.
I copy, and they're moving to the west. Okay, and you're still go. Engineering director.
Launch director, this engineering director. I have pulled the technical community, and you will have our consensus to proceed with this launch. Good luck and Godspeed.
Copy, KSC safety and quality director.
This is the walkway used by the astronauts to enter the orbiter. In case of an emergency, the arm can be placed back into position within about 15 seconds.
Okay, we copy.
Coming up on the 4 minute point in the count. The orbiter flight control surfaces, such as elevon, speed brakes, and rudders, are now being moved through a pre-programmed pattern. It's all three engines now being moved in a pattern to verify their readiness to support the ascent flight control. After going through their paces, they'll be aligned to their start positions. Coming up on the 2 minute point in our countdown. T-minus 2 minutes and counting. The orbiter computers have positioned the vent doors. T-minus 31 seconds. We have a go for auto-sequence start. Discovery's four redundant computers have assumed. T-minus 23 seconds and counting. The SRB nozzle profile. T-minus 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, we're go for main engine start. 7, 6, start. 3, 2, 1, 0, and liftoff! Liftoff! Americans return to space as Discovery clears the tower.
Roger, roll, Discovery.
Crew confirms roll program, Houston now controlling. Three engines at 104%. Three good APUs, three good fuel cells. Standing by to begin throttle down to 65%. Engine throttling down now to maintain a certain speed as the spacecraft passes through max Q. Three engines at 65% now. Standing by to see engines begin to throttle back up at about 59 seconds. Mark 1 minute, velocity 2,300 feet per second, altitude 5.9 nautical miles, downrange distance 3 nautical miles.
Discovery, go at throttle up.
Roger, go.
Discovery given a go at throttle up, three engines at 104%, velocity 3,200 feet per second, altitude 10.8 nautical miles, downrange distance 8 nautical miles. About 25 seconds from solid rocket booster separation. 1 minute, 45 seconds, three engines at 104%. Velocity 4,800 feet per second, altitude 20 nautical miles, downrange distance 19 nautical miles. Standing by for solid rocket booster separation.